do manage to reach that. We've got a couple of weeks still. Our goal is to sell 15 in total. So I guess if you just bought one, Papa Mitch, which if you did, then thank you very much. If you can get to 15 sold, I would be very impressed, and I would be actually kind of amazed, and it would be really awesome. So that'd be really cool. So that's our goal of those as we get ready to jump into this ZVZ. Let's introduce our players. It has been some early pool action in this game. As to the top left side, we have our blue Zerg player. It is Horror, as these two teammates go head to head against each other here. And to the bottom right is from MVP as well, Pet. Pool, gas pool opening. As Pet gonna look to put on the aggression right at the start of this game. So we're gonna be seeing the coming up towards the upper left side of the map. So some Zerglings gonna be coming in here and looking to get some damage done initially. Horror has actually made a big drone transfer down to the low ground, which he's now gonna have to pull back up to the high ground, and he's not I mean, that's going to hurt him because it's a lot of lost mine time with drones just transferring around here. As his first Zerglings getting quite a bit of damage done. Link Speed's on the way. He catches a couple of Zerglings as well with a surround. So, Pet getting a good start to this right now. As we see the Link's just pulling back a little bit. So, Link's just pulling back a little bit here. We've got the drones have come back to the low ground, but they're going to go back up to the high ground now. As we see Horror really realizing how much of a commitment this is. So, actually, lots of lost mining time from Horror. And that's the sort of thing which might lead to him kind of losing out in this game. Now, Bane and S finishes, so we see the first Banes begin to morph in. 1, 2, 3, and probably a 4th here in a second on that Zergling there. Really like the fact that he took his damaged Zerglings as well to morph into Banes, because of course they get healed up when they finish morphing into the next unit along, basically. As Pet going to hit that Zergling speed, he's going to start coming in here. And we're going to see him running around, looking to see what he wants to try and get up to. As we're going to see a... Well, something just been cancelled. I'm not sure what exactly is. The base spinning hit goes off pretty well. The next spinning is they don't really want to use themselves just yet. They'd rather kind of be used once they get up this ramp on the drones or on further Zerglings that come out here. As Pet really is looking to get quite a bit done. The spank pole goes down as well. This queen to the right hand side goes down. We use it. Oh, the bins actually get used there on the queen on the ramp. Another couple of bins on the way down for Pet as Horror getting a few more Zerglings out. Still without gas here. Is currently in a little bit of an issue as he does cancel one of them's Banelings morphing in. Actually, the other Baneling doesn't get too much done as Pet is running out of steam here a little bit. Another spank puller building on this natural expansion. Still Horror leading by 6 workers. Queen's going to continue to help defend. 2 more Banes already morphing in. Where are they? They're actually up on the high ground, and one of them gets cancelled, which is big as these Banes come in, and that's going to be a pretty good connection, but not good enough, I don't think. I still think Horror's in an alright sort of position here, with 2 spines on the way up, still a worker lead too, and a hatchery lead as well. Whereas it looks as though Pet is not going to be able to make this happen. This Baneling going to get cancelled as well, and Horror will force Pet away. Now, there is still ways for Pet to make this work, as he has a couple of spine crawlers towards the front here. So, so yeah, we're going to see a couple of spine crawlers morphing in towards the front. And we are going to see Pet looking to try and just keep on breaking this. You know, he's still making units. He still wants to try and break this, but the spine's going to make it difficult. I wonder if it's just worth making it. I say this a lot, but no one ever seems to do it. I've seen True do it once. Make an Evo Chamber and just start dropping up into the main and avoid those spine crawlers and the wall off as well. It could be so effective. It could be so useful. Of course, he doesn't really have an overlord in position to do that just yet. But it's definitely something you could try and do. And I mean, it's something that could be kind of useful to kind of get by the first, you know, Queen Wall, which kind of lost him so much time in this attack. And anyways, I'm also going to see the Spankler and Burrowing just going to move a little bit further forwards. Ling is still trying to come in here from Pet. He is starting a hatchery back at home, but just isn't finding himself any real damage in this game. And Horror, with 2 spines set up, is very, very safe now for a lot of the remainder of this game. You'll hold a worker lead as well, and a faster hatchery, more queens. In general, he's just, you know, he just holds all the advantages. Starts to take a second gas, as he's only just started mining off of his first gas. We'll see if he actually wants to commit into Link Speed. He might just decide to go straight into Roaches from this position. With 2 spines already up, he's very safe to do that. Doesn't necessarily need to go into Link Speed and so on. His Pet will go straight in towards a lair here. So trying to transition, but has definitely come out of this behind. A few drones going to transfer down to the low ground as the gold base here finally going to be set up for Pet, as there we are going to see the Evo Chamber and Rotoron coming in. So again, I mean, when there's two spines up and lots of queens as well, you may as well just go straight into the Rotoron and the Evo Chamber. I mean, if you don't have speed already, I mean, what, you know, against speed that's lit, it's not going to give him a lot in the game. I mean, sometimes you can maybe use a counter attack and try and deny the third base, etc. But I think just going straight into the roaches just makes this so, so strong for him now. His own lair's on the way up, and I imagine Pet's going to look to drop a spider here off of his lair. Four gas has been taken almost straight away. No sign of a Rotoron or anything, so probably going to spire, and Pet attempting to play the Mutalisks in towards the mid game. So, Rotoron about to finish up as well for Horus, so that's about to finish up over here. That's plus one starts for him too. And again, he's heading into a very, you know, strong roach opening, whereas his opponent going for Mutalisk. So both players taking different tech routes into the mid game now that we're starting to get there. A couple of lings having to be a little bit cautious, a little bit careful. There's a little bit of damage just come down onto them. We see an overlord just moving over to the left hand side a little bit. Just getting a little bit more vision of his main base, just in case any kind of Nidus network comes in or so. Especially when you're playing with Mutalisks, I mean, a Nidus network can be game-changing, so... In fact, there is actually a Nidus network on the way in the production tab, so... Horror is going into this Nidus network play. He's, you know, he's figuring out, I think, that this is going to be maybe Mutas from his opponent, and if not Mutas, then something he can punish with Nidus anyway, so... He's going to go for this, and... Well, I don't blame him. He's got plenty of queens, so I mean, the mutas aren't going to be very effective. Lots of transfuses on the queens as well, which is also important. And his roach is getting ready to go into that Nidus, and... Well, I mean, what we're going to see, I mean, we see a couple of Banes getting ready to come in to maybe stop this Nidus coming up, but... I don't know what he can really do. He's getting some more Banes out, but... I mean, there's even mutas aren't ready to go just yet. 700, 800 gas in the bank. The Spire's about to finish, but he doesn't actually have the minerals yet. Can he burst down the Nidus quick enough? Yes, he can. Banelings, man. Banelings are pretty good. Gonna rebuild another Nidus here, but he's gonna get denied again, and actually we're probably gonna have to see a Nidus coming up towards the front instead. He's already got that queued up, ready to go. As these Banelings once again just gonna blow up this Nidus so quickly. I didn't realize Banelings were so good at blowing up the Nidus network, man. Horror has been having two Niduses denied already. Now he's got one coming in towards the front, but if Pet can continue to deny these, then Horror is really gonna start losing out in this game. I mean, Queens can still come out and transfuse it. No. Absolutely, completely denied. Back in towards the main base, already a Banelings in position. I can't believe Pet is actually making such a sick hold of this. I didn't even know this was a possibility. I mean, with this much damage starting to go down, this is the sort, you know, with this much damage, you know, lack of damage coming in, as, oh, this time the Nidus does come up, and he is targeting still. Transfusers have come down. Well, a few queens get out, but only a few. A lot of roaches get out, though, and they may still be able to do the damage. Pet denied this for so long. But in the end, he just ran out of Banelings, and now another Nidus will come up, and now this might be where the problem is, because these mutas will not clean out these roaches very quickly. And this could really be the issue now, as some Zerglings come in. You're going to see them surround another one of these roaches here. We see Nidus on the low ground is unable to unload as well, and this is where, you know, Pet really gets into trouble, because even if he can clean up all of the queens, the roaches just do so much damage before they die off. And, well, Horror comes in. He's got plus one as well, so the Zerglings die so quickly, being two shot by the roaches instead of three shot. And that is a big, big factor in this, as these roaches continue to pull back. More lings running in. They're getting cleaned on up, as these last few drones as well are going to be, well, getting picked away at two. Now Horror at a 10 worker lead. He's got more and more queens coming out of this Nidus network as well. Whoa, a bit of a luck spike there. As we have the mutas going to come in and look to try and see what they can get up to. Coming in, they're going to target that Nidus. The Nidus might go down. Triple transfuses on it. Oh, one transfuser. He missed the next one. As the roaches coming forwards again, if the mutas are over here, then they are not in the natural, and that's where the roaches are attacking into. As Pet continues to try and hold on, there's a lot of mutas here. We're going to see the queens starting to transfuse each other, the lings getting cleaned out, and now the queens can start focusing on the mutas, but there's not enough, actually. As we see another Nidus coming up, but only roaches inside. The queens have gone down again, and Horror, well, he's just got to rely, that his, you know, rely on his roaches to do enough damage here, because he's not going to be able to deal with the mutalisks. And... Well, with this Mutacan getting higher and higher, this gets better and better for Pet. Okay, he's losing workers still, but so much potential on the counterattack of the Mutalisks as well. And that might be what we see here very soon, as a few roaches come up towards this other gold base. Oh, okay, I think Pet actually might be losing a few too many drones. He's now half the worker supply of his opponent, and still roaches in the main base too. Mutas don't get a chance to counterattack here, unfortunately. If they did, that really could have maybe been the way for him to come back into this game. With the Hydrogen only just on the way up, there's no spores in the mineral lines though, so again, if the mutas could make it over there, it could have been great, but they're just not quite able to make it happen. as we see the mutants coming in, just cleaning out a few more of these roaches. And we see the roaches getting blown up. Killing off a few more drones. 11 workers now for Pet. Eventually, Horror will win this out. He will win this, I think. But Pet's made an incredible defense, and well, I mean, with mutants, anything is possible, I suppose. Maybe he can find some magic trades. He's gonna need to trade like crazy. Crazy, crazy good if he wants to make this happen. As you see the mutants coming up towards the left side of the map, so he's finally got himself a chance to move across here. But just as the Hydras are starting to come out now, if the Hydras get split up a little bit, these mutants could maybe still fight against those. As you see him coming in, has to be careful though, has to be cautious. As he's gonna see what he can do. Oops, doesn't want to lose a few mutants like that. Kills off an overlord to begin with. No spore crawlers, so completely reliant on the Hydras actually. Which I find kind of interesting, to go completely reliant on the Hydras. And if Pet had some Lings left and some Banes, these Hydras just might die. And that's going to be a little bit of an issue, as we see these mutants continuing to work their way on this gold base on the left hand side. And he might be able to get, you know, bring this down to a 2 base versus 2 base game. As an overlord will go down. Mew's going to be coming back over towards the bottom right side of the map, because it's actually all he has to really deal with these roaches. And as he's trying to drone back up here, he loses even more. These three roaches just doing so, so much as they play a ring around the hatchery. And they will eventually get cleaned up, the roaches that is. The drones, a few of them surviving, but more damage being done. How many workers have been killed? 35. Not quite the 60 which True killed against Ayasonu earlier. As we see these mutas coming out in towards the middle of the map, some Zerglings too. And they're going to just, well, continue to hunt overlords. And I mean, again, mutas can trade very efficiently, but if these Hydras ever get across to the bottom right side, how do you then ever fight against this, as Hydras will not quite find a mutalist just yet. Pet fighting to stay in. There's a few Banes on the way. And again, Banes do very good against Hydralisks. I mean, okay, maybe not without Bane and speed, but it's still worth trying, I think, here. As we see a few Lings, a few Banes continue to come in. Do you have Burrow? No. I mean, maybe if you could invest into Burrow and Burrow Banes and then unburrow on the Hydras or something. Something like that could maybe win him the game. Like, if he unburrowed on this clump of Hydras and then come in for the mutas, maybe something like that is what we need. As we see these mutas coming in, they're going to start working their way on this hatchery. Sporecrawler gets a little bit of damage done, but not too much. Hydras getting a couple of hits off as well. As Pet is kind of going for one attack here that's, he's hoping we'll win him the game, as the Ling is going to start running in. He's going to start fighting as these Hydras, they just move command backwards. The Banelings, though, without Banelings speed, do not get here fast enough. And yeah, the mutas are going to be in a lot of trouble. There's just way too many Hydralisks, and Pet is not going to get enough done here. This will be GG. And game number one will go the way of Horror. Lots of action coming up here on the stream. So don't forget to drop that follow if you're enjoying the games and enjoying the action and the casting and whatever else. As we have to the upper right side of the map, our blue Zerg player from MVP in this team kill finals, best of five. It is, oops, this mouse man, it is Horror. As to the bottom left side, it's gonna be our red Zerg player. Newest addition to MVP, it is Pet. Hatch first from both players in game number two of this series. Now, it's just going to be Pet moving away from that early aggression, which did not work out too well for him in the very early stages of Prior and Terraces. It's a little bit of a slower opening here, and as we get set up and ready to go. Again, Hatch first player coming in down from both players. Gas on the way, Extractor on the way, and a spawning pool also coming down as we just get set up. It's actually free hatch before pool from Horror. This is something we've seen a few times now in ZVZ. I actually saw Tefl doing it originally way back a couple months ago in ZVZ. I believe it was used in Pro League recently as well. I can't remember who. I think it was someone. I think it was in Rogue's game. Rogue versus Bjoll? ? Maybe? Something like that. It was one of those players, I think. You know, basically, unless it goes punished very early in the game, you know, if it goes unpunished early in the game is a more eloquent way to say it. If it goes unpunished early in the game, then you kind of end up with an extra hatchery, an extra production, and you can really spam out Lings. Like, you can really, really spam out Lings. But it's not game-ending if you don't punish it. I mean, Pet has potential to scout this and just say, okay, well, I'm just going to fast bird of my own. I still have some faster queens, I have a little bit faster production. And maybe I can still trade a bit too. It's kind of one of these things which I've only seen a handful of times, so it's very hard to kind of really analyze and talk about in detail. So always interesting to see how it plays out in between these two players. As we see this overload coming in from Petters, not going towards that third just yet, so does not know about the speed of this third base. The other thing as well, on a map like this, to do this build on this map, or just towers for example, is really great also, because you don't actually know if this is the natural expansion or if it's the third base, because you can't see that base in the back right of the base, in the back right of the base here, for a long time. So he doesn't actually know if this is the second or third. So, you know, that's Pet just going to start taking his third base now on the low ground nice and early on. As we will see him come across here for a single Zerglin, but will get turned away by these Lingers at the front. So Ling's going to be continuing to chase here. Now, it will be Pet with the faster Zerglin speed, so maybe he can turn around and fight this. Maybe latch onto that first Ling at the front very easily. Or maybe just turn around completely. He has got a little bit less health, and he will just not take a better fight here. Comes in, tries to re-engage, but Horror turns around to fight at the perfect times. As more Lings coming across the map, so Pet really going to pressure onto this base, onto this play from his opponent. Is it going to be enough, though? A few Banes already starting to morph in from Pet over to the right-hand side. However, one of them is very low on health. The second one is also very low on health, and that's actually two Banes now cancelled here. So, Horror already kind of halving the threat of Banelings in this game. As he has his own Banes on the way up. Queen not in position to block that wall just yet, though. As Ling's already starting to stream up this ramp. And that's one Queen down already. The Queen's on the ramp does not have a transfuse just yet. As we see a couple of Banes coming through. What are they going to connect on? Gets a Queen and two, three Banelings as well for his troubles. And as these Banelings continue to drop down. And we see a few more Zinglings coming in from Pet. Doesn't seem as though he's got enough to really take this fight, though. And he will just have to back away for now and start to drone up himself. He is a little bit behind that work count, and so his early aggression has not quite worked out for him here. So Zergon's going to be coming along to the bottom left for Pet, just going to be coming back to his own base. We're going to see Horror looking for a little bit of a counter-attack right now. And this kind of attack has the potential to do a little bit. Of course, it always comes down in these Ling Bane wars to how good them Bane connections will be, how good the control from each player is. Although right now, Pet is only just going to have one single Baneling ready to go. As these first Baneling's coming in, and again, you've got to look for them Bane connections. First one from Horror is actually pretty good here, as we see him continuing to dodge away from the Baneling of his opponent. As we see that one last Zergling getting a connection there. A few Banelings on the ramp now for Pet, though. And again, just Ling Bane back and forth action. Horror with the slight worker lead, but that's about it, as he will get turned away. A couple more Banes coming in. And then again, just taking a couple of trades here and there. I'm going to try and get himself maybe a Queen kill, but unlikely to really kind of get the kill on this, as Pet will clean on up. So very similarly, kind of a very even game right now. Actually, the work count is even evened out. Both players on three bases. The unit count is very similar. Just Pet down a single Queen. As we see him dropping a Spire as his mid-game tech choice with his lair already finished. That's something he has, his opponent does not. So he's already got a lair. And he's going to go into the Rotoron as well. So Horror going to be... I'm just fucking up today. Rotoron comes down for Horror, and the lair tech from Pet is going to be the Spire. So we'll see what Horror wants to go into, if he's going to go for an aggressive Roach Ling time, and it'd be super aggressive and just kind of kill his opponent right now. Looks as though he will be. Lots more Roaches on the way up, and lots of Lings as well. So not taking into the lair, not dropping an Evo Chamber, just going to be saying, right, Roaches, Lings, plenty of units, get them across the map, try and end this game now. Spire's on the way up, but again, similar situation to last game, where the Mutas might not be in a high enough number to clean up these Roaches quickly, and that might just kind of be the issue here for Pet, where he's not able to kill these Roaches quickly enough, and so he still ends up taking a lot of damage. As we see a bunch of Spine Crawlers coming in at this third base, we see Uniscorton come forwards, lots of Banes as well. I mean, these Spines take a little bit of damage off them, a couple of Banes. Actually, most of the Banes being used up here, and that's really nice, because now it means Horror can bring his own Banes in without fear of them being kind of blown up inefficiently. He has to back away, wants to fight away from the Spine Crawlers if possible. These Banelings are going to be a big part of this to kind of help burst down some of the Spine Crawlers. As he comes on through, he's going to burst down Spine in the back, and that's going to help out a lot, as Horror just seems to have a little bit too much right now. 9 Mutas on the way, but as we mentioned, them 9 Mutas, when they come out, it's going to take them a long time to deal with these Roaches, and so Horror is going to get at least enough damage to make this worthwhile. As he starts going into the main, I like this, dealing with the Lings at the drones at the third base with a few Lings, going into the main and just maximizing his damage here. As again, the Mutas about to start popping. As you see, 30 more Lings were just in the production tab for Horror. He's going to stream these across the map. And again, he's already taken a worker lead. I feel like it's going to be a very similar scenario to that last game, where Horror's got an advantage. Maybe he can't end the game because the Mutas will keep on continuing to clean up eventually. but you'll have enough of an advantage to eventually win. It's just a case of making sure he doesn't kind of die off to the Muta counterattack or anything. As the Zerglings coming through, and they're going to come in, surround the third hatchery here, so that will fall. And it's kind of funny how similar a scenario is since the last game, with the Mutas trying to clean up and Pet falling behind, but maybe with the Mutas can maybe get something done. And as the Zerglings continue to stream across, you get a bit more damage. And of course, no Nidus network means that Horror will not be able to continue this aggression for too long, and will have to go into his Spore Crawler production nice and quickly, but takes a 25 worker lead, 8 more drones being made as we continue in this game. So, Pet survives. And with Pet surviving, we're going to see the game continue. But I mean, surviving and being in this game are two very different things. Now, the Mutas, again, they have a lot of potential here. If the Mutas can get enough damage done, this game could definitely even up. It could definitely go. I mean, it sounds crazy, but it could. I mean, the Mutas are one of these units which can, if you've got enough of them, if your opponent isn't prepared enough, can bring you, you know, into the game again. And we actually see Zerglings coming across here as well from Pet. And then Lings, if they get rid of a couple of Spore Crawlers on this low ground, well, this could be completely game-changing. So Pet has already started to do what he needs to get done here. These Lings coming across, getting a lot done. I like this. The Mutas just kind of camping the ramp and killing off a couple of Lings which come down, killing off the Queens which come into play as well, targeting down the Queens with the most energy to get rid of the Transfuse also. Very, very smart players. Pet actually has so many units in power, doesn't actually have anything right now. He's lost so many queens, his Lings are getting demolished as well. And Horror is about to find himself down on workers, I think, because Pet is just getting so much done. I would have maybe liked it if Pet actually runs into this third base, so I don't like that. I would have preferred if he came in here and actually worked his way against some of these Spore Crawlers with the Zerglings, because that's one way he can then guarantee himself a kill on the third base. Horror will stabilize slightly. The number of Spore Crawlers he has really helps him out in terms of the Mutas not really being able to do too much. As he comes in, gets another hit on the Spore there, and just continue to work against it. Some Zerglings come in, they actually trap the Lings of Horror and allow the Mutas to be able to connect with them. Some more Banes coming in as well. Horror's still down, 12 army supply to 34. He lost a lot committing to that attack across the map, and okay, he got damage done, but again, as I said, the Mutas are, you know, this count, you know, this unit, which if he gets a counterattack off, it's like the last game we were saying, if he gets a counterattack off, he might be able to do damage, but the Nidus allowed him to continue attacking. That's not the scenario here. He doesn't have a Nidus. Now we see Pet continue to connect with Banelings into the mineral lines, gets only one drone, but gets a couple of them low, which means Zerglings can pick them off more easily. As them Ling's going to come in, work away the spores on the third, and again, I think that's a very good decision, because it means that the third base is now going to be able to be attacked by Pet. Here comes in with a few more Zerglings of his own. Horror's starting to catch up in army supply. Some Queen's going to come in to try and help against these Mutas. As Pet has not droned up at all. He's still only on 19 workers at this point in the game. As we see, Queen's continue to trade with the Mutas, but there's just not quite enough for the Queen's. I mean, they take off one more Muta here, but it costs him 3 Queen's in doing so, which he can sort of afford because he's ahead in the economy. But I think eventually, I think eventually, Pet might just work his way into an advantage. Especially if Pet droned up. I mean, it's kind of a fine line though, because if you drone up, you lose your momentum on this side of the map. If you lose your momentum on this side of the map, maybe that's your one chance gone to win this game. As the Hydroden starts to come down, so Horror going into the same answer as what he had in the Polymeters in the last game, which is going to be the Hydralis. He has lots and lots of gas. He has loads of gas, actually. I mean, so much gas available to him that he might just be able to get enough Hydras out. He's going to be supply blocked though, and that means he has to spend some of his money on further overlords now. Please see those Zerglings. No, he builds the overlords at the third base. That's kind of silly. Kind of panicking a little bit here. I mean, he should be building those in the main, the natural, where they're defended by spores. They're probably just going to go down here. You know, they're probably just going to go down here if the Mutas do see them. As he actually comes into the main base right now, looking to get something done. Starting to stream in here with some Zerglings. Banelings also making their way forwards. Out of range of spores once again, as we see the Queens starting to fight. The mineral line in the natural is being ravaged. The Mutas target down the Banelings, so the Zerglings going to continue to ravage that mineral line. Pet takes a worker lead. He's droned up to 32, and he's going to take out so many of his opponent's drones. GG. And best of 5. Let's go in and introduce our players. The top left side of the map, our blue Zerg player. From MVP, will be Horror. A little bit of discussion about that last game in the chat, and well, let's talk about it in a moment. Let's introduce our player first. So the bottom left, it's going to be our purple Zerg. It is going to be Pet. As I see, actually, hatch gas pool from Pet, and an aggressive, well, not really aggressive, but a defensive gas pool out of Horror. So this allows him to get his Zergling speed up and a hatchery up. It allows him to go into a fast Ling speed slash Bane nest, while also still going to a pretty fast hatch of his own. So slight build advantage to Pet, just because he plays kind of brave, a bit more brave, and takes a bit of a risk, and will more or less get away with it here. A bit of a discussion about the last game in the chat. I mean, the thing is, when you make a bit of... The problem was, Horror messed up a little bit at first against the Mutas. And when he messed up at first against the Mutalisks, Mutas are a real snowball unit. Like, if you don't have your defense set up against them, you're in trouble. I think the mistake Horror really made was continuing to try and defend the third base. He's far enough ahead that if he just sits on two bases, he'd be fine. But he spent so many queens and so on trying to defend the third that if he'd actually just defended his natural and main instead, then he's got Spore Crawlers to fight with. He's got a lot more Lings that never get wasted, kind of being killed off by Mutas because they're running down trying to protect the third. And he gets into... He can drop his Hydra down, get into Hydras, and he probably finds himself in a similar position to the last game. So I kind of feel as though it was just a bit of a slip-up, really, by Horror, just kind of deciding to try and defend the third. Maybe really thinking he was more ahead than he was. I mean, he was very far ahead, let's not deny that. But maybe just thinking he could defend that third, and when he couldn't, he'd actually lost enough trying to... that it became a bit of a snowball effect, and then Mutas just basically ended up winning the game for Pet. Well, not basically, I mean, they straight up did. It was the Mutas and not really much else that allowed Pet to make that comeback, as we have this game starting up. Of course, second speed is a little bit faster for Horror based on the opening, but he's a bit down in workers. Again, Pet getting a bit of a build order advantage at the start of this game. As these couple of lings do come across here for Pet. Try to have a bit of a look to see what's going on, but they will just go down if they continue trying to fight. And actually, one of them, Zergling's getting caught by these few lings over here. As that one Zergling should go down. And Horror is committing to a lot of lings across the map here. A few Banes starting to morph in. Now, Ling Speed and Bane Nest is not far away at all for Pet. There's his first Bane Lings actually morphing in right now. His Zergling's down here on the low ground too. Just going to be keeping on coming out. So this should be okay, I think, for Pet. He's also got the kind of the choke point here to put his queens into. To help him defend, and he'll keep his queens towards the ramp here, I imagine, to try and target down those Banelings. Wants to avoid the Banelings of his bunch just there, so he doesn't really want to trade 3 for 2, but he does end up trading 3 for 2. So not the best of trades for Pet, but he does survive, and his own Zerglings on the way out now. He's actually going to cancel these Banelings, no problem, and he will counterattack here as well. He's 5 workers ahead from this early aggression now. Horror is beginning to drone up, but his Pet, he's been on the aggression, so now Horror takes the lead. I mean, it's the back and forth ZVZ kind of cat and mouse game of Ling Bane in the early stages of this. These Lings coming in, and they're going to be trying to get some more damage done. Now, Bane is not quite ready for Horror, as we see Pet trying to target down a couple of those. In the end, the trades are fairly even, and we see, well, again, it comes down to Bane connections. As, ooh, the Bane connections actually turned out to be okay. Two Banes with two Banes in the end, as Pet continues to try and work his way into this mineral line. And he's starting to kind of just have too many units compared to his opponent. He's got a lot of these drones on low health, and he picks off a lot of those thanks to those earlier Bane connections. And now Horror finds himself back down four workers as Pet drones up a little bit more once again back at home. So we're going to see a couple of Banes coming forwards, and you're going to see these couple of Banes looking for some connections, and they do find those connections here as a little bit of a skirmish comes down to the left-hand side. As his Ling Bane action continues, it's going to be Pet who takes the first step out of the Ling Bane as he starts to drop down a Rotor, and a couple of Banes starting to come in once again from Horror. He's going to keep on, I mean, he's going to drop a Bane in a Rotor in right now as well. So both players looking for the Rotor transition here as the game continues. No Evo Chambers just yet, no Lairs, both of them realizing this is a fragile situation where if they overcommit to tech, they might very well just die to the pressure of their opponents. Ooh, that was nearly a very big Bane connection. Horror then manually detonates on nothing. So not too much done there once again, as it is Pet who definitely comes out of the lead. You know, 9 workers ahead, only 5 workers building for Horror. Pet definitely in the end has worked his magic and come out ahead in all of this, which I think is kind of was kind of the initial kind of situation anyways. He was ahead on the build order advantage, and he was ahead on the build order, and he kind of defended the first wave of aggression pretty well too. So Pet comes out ahead, and we'll see how the game transitions now, as we do see Pet safe enough, or feeling safe enough at least, to drop down the lair. Now, the third base of Pet will be taken down in this location here, rather than kind of taking it up here, which can be maybe a bit harder to hold against Mutalisks and so on, and even Roaches if they break down these rocks. So it's kind of a better spawning location for Horror, because he can take his third base with this rocks, these rocks kind of, you know, he can take the third base further back from his opponent, while these rocks are also protecting it too. So less of an open third base, and no run by is really potential to, you know, be able to go in there. So a bit of an advantage in the spawning location for Horror. As we see, Pet is chasing down some more Zerglings still. Still a bit of a worker lead, as Looks as though he's gone into the lair, but I don't think he's actually going to go in for roaches. I think he's going to drop the spire here in a couple of moments. I mean, he's gone spire two games in a row so far. Obviously, the playstyle he's been enjoying so far this series. Okay, now he actually drops the plus one. Okay, I was kind of maybe missed the Evo Chamber going up in production tab. So, with the Evo Chamber, he will start plus one. I was just feeling he was taking a lot of gas and not really making any roaches to kind of defend with or anything. I didn't see the Evo, and so I was kind of just feeling he might drop the spire. But no, it is going to be plus one. It is going to be roach speed. And a very similar thing going to be coming up for Horrors, his own lair and Evo Chamber just a little bit later than his opponents. So Pet, slight upgrade in the lair timing, slight upgrade in roach speed timing and plus one timing. And of course, slight work leads still at this point in the game too. But with a more exposed third base to try and defend against his opponent's aggression. A few Ravagers going to be coming up, and as we'll see, Pet continue to defend. Both players setting up into free base play. Neither of them looking to kind of go super aggressive or anything. Horror actually looking to stay on the defensive as he starts up a couple of spines. And I wonder if we see a middle transition from either of these players. Again, something we've seen a couple of times today already. The Roach into middle's playstyle here in the ZVZs. Maybe something we do see once again here. We'll find out very shortly, I guess, as this Oblup continues to dodge. Has two hits left on it before it goes down to one of these Ravagers. We'll need one hit from death now, and it will go down. So, Overlord picked off here, a very small victory for Pet, but actually will pop Horror into a supply block. So, you can see Pet's actually supply is just completely exploding here. Now, imagine he'll try and attack with Roach Ravager very soon with his plus one Roach speed finishing up. And, well, his supply really is exploding. 62 army supply to 18. That's the power of not being supply blocked, and also just the worker lead he had for a lot of this game. You know, slight inefficiencies in the build order throughout for Horror, who's built a couple of spines, which don't help him. You know, it costs him 200 minerals and it throws away a couple of drones. You know, instead, you know, he's been behind on economy and, you know, he's just not been making moves which bring him back into the game. Unfortunately, as we see Pet, he's not going to attack just yet. Still milking more roaches. I would like to see him at least just try to poke forwards and see what he can get done as he's continues to try and pick off an Overlord here in the center. So Pet is going to be coming through and attacking towards the front here as we do see this army starting to move out onto the map and looking as though he wants to try and push up into this position. He does supply block Horror once again with another Overlord kill thanks to them corrosive spells. Now plus one is about to finish for Horror, so there's not going to be an upgrade advantage here for Pet. And he would be attacking up a ramp into Spinecrawlers too, but does he just have the numbers to allow him to do this? He uses corrosive spells to push his opponent back, stands in a couple corrosive spells of his opponent though, which isn't good for him as he starts to take this fight again. I think it just might be too many years for Pet, and I think Horror might be taking a bit of a deficit in this game as Pet might be going on to match point in this best of five series. Moving on through, taking down his last few Ravagers, and they are dropping here, and that will be GG. Pet takes it in game number three. Pet. It's 2-1 to Pet, which means Horror is down a game. He spawns on the upper right side of Dusk Towers as the blue Zerg player. And down to the bottom left, our red Zerg player from MVP. This is a team kill in today's finals. It's going to be Pet. Gaspool opening, very aggressive opening once again, back to what he was doing on Prior and Terraces. Now, it was free hatch before Bull and Orbital Shipyard. If Horror went for something similar here, he might find himself in a lot of trouble, and this is the sort of thing where the gas pool opening will just completely build order win against a free hatch before pool. So let's see if Horror does that again. Let's see if he's a bit too predictable, basically, as we get ready to go into this. We're going to see gas coming down. So it's just going to be Horror actually going into Hatch Gas Pool. And this is what he defended with in game number one. And so let's see if he is able to defend here once again. There's going to be a queen here to start for Pet as well as six things. Of course, the queen pretty important to get that production up. You're only on one hatchery, so you need those injects to be coming out. Katak ID, I'm sorry. I'm just a bit... I didn't mean to rage at you a bit in the chat. I'm just really frustrated with hearing the same shit over again. Even though I've kind of explained it like 1,000 times. Sorry, I didn't mean to be so BM. I do apologize as we jump into this. My t-shirt neckline's completely fucked. Dan Holmes, just go leave the channel. You literally just complain about all of it. Like, if you're just gonna complain about everything in the stream, why are you even here? You literally told me I was being a complete idiot saying that Pet had a chance in the game on Orbital Shipyard, which he then won. So maybe you're just the idiot. Maybe you're just a complete fucking idiot in this scenario. Honestly. Because all you've been doing is talking shit since you joined the channel. So why don't you just leave, please? Or someone ban him or something. Oh, I'm tilted. I am tilted. You've done it, Twitch chat. It's taken you years, but you've actually managed to fucking tilt me. You've literally managed to tilt me. Some lings coming across the map. And I'm going to see these kind of taking a bit of an engagement here as, again, ling speed about to kick in. So Horror not really realizing that what's going on here just yet. Is I don't have these lings out on the map, and they might get caught before he gets home. He's got his queens up on the ramp to defend. He's got some drones here to defend too for a little bit of extra damage, I imagine. He lets a couple of them go back. Maybe just to try and help with the queens a bit, maybe mess with the AI and keep them queens alive just a little bit longer. So them queen drones do go down, the queens will survive a bit longer because of it, and we will now see transfusers available on one of these queens, and we will see the transfusers exchanged here in just a couple of seconds. As we get set up and ready to go, queens are going to go down, we're going to see Banelings going off, and we'll see these Berserkers actually making their way through the ramp, and we do see some Banes on the way up on the high ground here, a couple of them about to come in. Them two, a few up here as well, about to come into play. The drones are all stacked up. There was the Banelings are coming on in. They're looking for connection. Oh, they're getting stuck, and they are going to see a big connection here as we see Horror dropping down to just 10 workers. The Banelings volume are cancelled, and there's so many Zillions left over. Pet is still doing so much damage in this mineral line. 13 workers to 5. The aggression is going to seem to work here in game number 4, and it looks as though Pet might be today's Dojo Cup champion. And taking home $75, 13 workers to 2 in the lead. All he has to do from here is continue to make units and should be in more than enough of an advantage to take this game. A couple of Banes will morph him back at home. Just has to play it safe against these initial units of his opponent. And then he should be completely fine. As we see the units, the lings coming across the map. As these, we see what's about to happen. These a couple of Banes coming in. The Bane kits are kind of important here because he was a little bit behind in army supplies as his attack got launched. And all he has to do is defend. If he defends, he's going to win this. And Horror, on 4 workers alone, is not going to be able to make a comeback. I mean, we saw Pet making a miraculous comeback before, but there's no comeback mechanism in the game right now for Horror. There's no mutilists or anything like that. As we see these Banes coming forwards, and Horror is going to be backing away. But what do you do from here? Well, that's the answer. GG. And that is going to be Pet